Let's get some battles here. Obviously going to play first. See. It's kind of an interesting opening hand. I don't think we can mulligan it. Have multiple Jaces. We have a CB on to draw some cards. We have a Halmar Depths to find a third land. Probably don't want both the 4Cs or both the Jaces. We're going to want to get rid of one of those, but CB on lets us do that. Not the greatest. I think we want to draw Preordain into Spell Pierce, and we don't want Embercool at all, so... We'll, I'm not sure if we're going to Preordain next turn into, and then draw Spell Pierce and do it, or if we're just going to see beyond. We'll obviously shuffle away an Embercool at that point. So, the one problem with that is we're not going to hit any lands, guaranteed. Uh-oh, Quest deck. This hand is not good against the Quest deck. So we'll probably be Preordaining. Actually, we'll probably be Sea Beyonding just to use up our mana. And then we'll shuffle Emrakul away. And then next turn we'll be able to Preordain into a land, hopefully. Maybe draw a land naturally, and then try to get a Pyroclast and Reverse Lightning or Lightning Bolt or something. So right now, this Glenhawk is going to kick our ass. Oh, no. So yeah, I assume the goal against this type of deck is just to combo off as fast as possible in game one, and then game two and three just be like a Wrath deck. Whether that works out in theory or... reality, I'm not sure. See if he plays his Ornithopter so he doesn't have to discard a card. I assume he will, but... Nope. It seems like maybe an oversight. Seems better to have a 0-2 in play. Yeah, he definitely didn't want to discard a Core Outfitter. Okay, so... looking for a Pyroclasm at this point. None of this is Pyroclasm, and we have a land in hand, so I'm going to go ahead and throw those on the bottom. Get another Preordain, so that's good. I'm going to do the same thing here. I do want a land, but I figure we're going to draw one. Play Spell Pierce, mana, or play an island, so we have Spell Pierce mana open. It's probably not going to be relevant, but... next turn we can start foreseeing, and hopefully find said Pyroclasm soon. Sure. Bounce a land, replay a land. Student of Warfare. Now would be a good time to just draw our Pyroclasm naturally. Unlikely, but... no. Alright, so we can Jace, Brainstorm with it. Not going to do a ton for us just because it's going to get attacked, and so we're going to gain 3 life and get a Brainstorm. Whereas 4C can at least find us Pyroclasm. It digs deeper. So we have Lightning Bolt, Explosive Revelation. So we're going to put these on bottom. 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 Top. Draw. And I guess already played a land. So I guess next turn we're probably going to be bolting plus 4C again, or bolt plus Jace is probably fine too. We're going to take a ton this turn, 3, 5, probably 8. Okay, Ornithopter, not sure what that accomplished. Alright, so we're not going to take 8, we're only going to take 6. So we'll be at 9, still digging for a Pyroclasm. We've seen a lot of cards, so we have a good shot at just drawing one. So here's kind of awkward, because we're going to have to play a land before we 4C, which means we can't play Halmar Depths. Another Lightning Bolt, a Burst Lightning, a Spell Pierce. All this is good, but I think we'll keep a Lightning Bolt. I mean, we're just trying. I guess lightning bolt doesn't even do anything. So we're gonna bolt one of these guys. Yeah, we need it to deal with the other X3. So I'm gonna keep it on top. Then we will bolt. If he doesn't level, we'll bolt the core Skyfisher. If he does level, we'll bolt the Student of Warfare. Then we will untap. Let's see, what don't I want? Probably a Spell Pierce. Untap and hope to draw Pyroclasm. Alright, so he didn't level, so we're going to kill the Skyfisher. Then we take 4, 5, 6, so we go to 3. I guess we could hope he doesn't level at all, and then Jace into a Pyroclasm. Seems difficult no matter what we do. Alright, he's definitely leveling. So if I bolt that, we're still taking 5. So yeah, I pretty much have to rip Pyroclasm here. Did not happen, so I think I'm drawing dead unless he attacks a Jace here. So I'm going to Brainstorm. Saw a lot of cards. Kind of sucks we didn't get our Pyroclasm. There's another bolt. So depending on what he does here, I could theoretically bolt him twice and then untap an Explosive Revelation for the win. Depends on what he does with his attacks. Get to kill two creatures here. So really, basically, if he alphas us, then we're dead. He has to attack Jace. Looks like he's attacking us. That was actually pretty close, though. We were basically a turn away from being able to kill him. So despite him having a decent draw on us, not hitting a Pyroclasm in 1,000 draws, we're only a turn away from getting there. Alright, so we got a bunch of cards boarded in. Bursties, Lightnings, Pyroclasm, Chain Reaction. Definitely taking out Spell Pierce. We'll get rid of that now. Mana Leak also seems bad. I guess one Calcite Snapper for now. What else do we want to take out for Calcite Snappers? It's not even the best card against him, just because it does not hit the flyers, and he's got a lot of flyers. I'll just bring in two for a 4C, and we'll see how that does. I don't think he won all four in this matchup, just because he has Glinthawks and Core Skyfishers, things like that. And while this guy's fine on the ground, he's not amazing. And we brought him a bunch of removal, so we'll bring in two for now, and if we go to game 3, we'll see if they're good enough to take out more of them.